Hello friends, in this video I'll be helping with system documentation. So let's start. So this is a bit different from software documentation, because in this the software documentation is also included, but in this you document whole of the system. For example, you are manufacturer of a washing machine, right? So in washing machine a particular software will also be installed, but with that a particular system is also there. So when you are documenting a washing machine or something like that, then it is called a system documentation, which includes software documentation as well. So it is a written illustration that is either explain how the system operates or how to use it. So it is simple, it is like a manual for everyone, for a developer, for an administrator, for a maintenance staff, and as well as for a customer, that is how it works or basically how to use it. So includes all the description, graphic programs, instruction pertaining to design, implementation, and operation of the system. So it contains each and everything, or you can say it contains every detail related to a particular system in our system documentation. So what are the five types of documentation manual? First is system design documentation. It is basically from the developer points of view, or you can say manufacturer points of view. So it is a purpose to provide technical details of a system at top level. So before developing, before manufacturing a system, you need to analyze what are the requirements, right? If you are developing a washing machine, then you need to understand, okay, what is required at today's time. Like you need a dryer, you need a timer, you need a different kind of wash for different kind of like clothes, right? And similarly, so you need to analyze each and every technical aspect, and that is contained in system design documentation, that what are the technical requirements of a particular system. Then it contains can be derived from end products of analysis phase. So whatever you analyzed, you can just write in system design documentation, and after that you can just work on that particular system. So what it consists of, it consists of formulation of problems, that what are the problems related to particular system. Then comes a feasibility issue, that okay, this particular system needs electric power, this particular system cannot operate at this temperature, and similarly, what are the feasibility issues related to that system is also contained in this. Then overview of the system is also there. Then comes output report and screen displays, that is pre-on giving input, what output we got from that, or what is the expected output from that particular system is, and what are the input and source documentation used, that is also written. So if you are having system design documentation, then you know about that how system will work and is system is working correctly or not. Then next comes software documentation. As I told you, software documentation is a part of it. Still, I will make a different video on it. So software documentation consists of three things. First is hardware specification, basically contain all the details of the hardware related to that particular software, to maintaining that particular software, that may be equipment, peripheral devices, or communication hardware. So different hardware used by that particular software. Next is system software specification, that is what are the OS used and what are the other system software that are used to maintain that particular software. Next comes application software, what are the application software that also need to be defined in that software documentation. Next is file design or database design. So if you are using a kind of database or you are using a file design, then you need to define a path to each file in that particular software. So these four things is contained in software documentation, basically everything related to software. Next comes operation documents. One thing, the video is going a bit longer than 4 minutes, but I guess like I couldn't explain this all in less than 4 minutes. That's why I'm taking it a bit more than 4 minutes, but I try to keep it always less than 4 minutes. So next is operation documents. So in this, the goal is basically to make a better understand to operations staff, that the one who will be handling that software, or basically the user who will be, or you can say the customer who will be handling that software, or you can the system, basically how to run program in proper order, how to distribute output, and if any error comes, then what we need to do. So it contains everything in that. So it contains a multiple system flowchart with supportive narrative. So if you got an error, then you have a flowchart that okay, these things you need to done in a form of flowchart, and the error will be removed. So if you are a operational staff, then you need to have operation documents. It is basically the user manual which contains error correcting technique also. Next comes is user reference documentation. It is basically from the user's point of view. It is basically, you can say, marketing point of view. So it is just informing user about that, okay, this is the system capable of, this is the input we gave. So it contains objectives of documentation, that what are the objective, what are the purpose and use of the document, why we are providing it, what are the input documents, what were the inputs that were provided to the system, and what were the expected output also is written. So it just tells about that, okay, this is the system capable of. And if when you buy a mobile, then you see that somewhere it's written that 10,000 screen test and 20,000 battery life, 500 times battery cycle. So these all are tests done, okay, these are all the inputs provided and these are all the output given. So this is just informing the user about that, okay, this is all the system is capable of. Next is processing logic and error condition. So if any error is you can say got incurred, then what do we need to do, what the user need to do, how to handle that error, that is also defined in user manual. Next is system maintenance and staff documentation. So this is in case of user is not able to handle a software or handle an error in a software, then what the user will do, when you buy a washing machine and you get an error that you can't rectify, then what you do, you just call to customer care and customer care sends someone to just rectify the system. So this contains the list of the person who will be contacting in case of the error will not be rectified by the customer. So these are all the documentation that we need to do, or basically this is what all system documentation is all about. So if you like the video, do hit the like button, do consider subscribing, and thanks for watching. And video got a bit long, but this was really needed. So if you like the video, do hit the like button. Till then, bye bye.